And we're going over to the continent of Africa, the motherland.
It is a pleasure to represent for... Hey!
Yes, my brother.
Yes, Professor Abugani. Give us your take on the stepanyries of the art of war. Elaborate.
Let me tell you that this is the greatest program that the world has ever seen. Hey, let me tell the people that are fighting against the Stephen Razor. You don't know what you are doing. It is obvious that you don't listen what the elders say. You don't listen when the elders say that a foolish dog bark at a flying bat. Hey, because the Stephen Razor is way up here. And you are way down there barking like a stupid dog.
Yeah, good afternoon. And next Thursday, upon the Stepping Razor, you listen to a bridging from Ghana named Black Prophet with Tyrus Riley. Dean Fraser production, may I tell you? So, and next Thursday, and we are here again, we continue the journey. Yes, the bridging there with him cologne. I see you sticking it up. But why, really, why hear the words about it still? That's why I'm playing that way. There. Trust me. Trust me. We really do hear the words. But we're there again. We're there again with you. You know, we have an interview here with Bert Samuel, attorney of law, about the reenactment of the case against Governor Ayre. You know, last year in October, we went to Morant Bay to view that trial. Well, they are going to do it again in a theater setting this time, and some different changes and additions have been made. So we want to talk to Bert about what is the changes and the additions that has been made to it. This is the Stepping Razor. I'm Mark Meyer. I'm trying Dean Fraser again. May I tell you? This is the Stepping Razor. Now we have a bridge in Panelina. Turn at law, Bert Samuel, Pan-Africanist. Stage
right. Oh, I'm the writer. Oh, you leave out that.
Wait no, man. Oh, you're jumping on me things, man. Speak when you are spoken to, man.
Yes, Judge.
Yes. Playwright, partially director. I mean...
No, sir, that's not me.
You know, partially directly. So, you know, man. Oh, you do. You're supposed to get enough work, man.
Yeah, you know, Hollywood.
I know Hollywood be a talk about as an attorney at law. The mountain mix up, you're going to Jamaica, you know, may I tell you.
Yeah, man. I'm sorry, you have to branch out, you know, find something else to do for the cause.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so let me know, say, this thing I do already, why was it necessary to do it again?
Why we go out at St. Thomas Cathedral? Because we have to show respect to that forgotten parish, that parish who suffered so much, and we decided, as you remember, to do it out there, to show the people that that is where the fire has to start.
Yeah,
so, we did it in St. Thomas, and then a lot of people, you know, the Kingston people don't like travel sometimes. Oh, come in and do it in the city. So it's all right. Them bring William Garden from St. Andrew, the parish of St. Andrew. So we do it in a Bogle parish. Now we are do it at William Garden parish.
So wait, you know, when somebody asks if you do a mobile, you know, we are going a mobile too.
Well, the mobile would have that if you have Sam Sharp. You have to, you know, show respect to Daddy Sam. So we go down there, man.
Yeah, all right. So what is, well, tell me some things were different in this one. Because we know that this time is a theater setting, right?
Yes, right.
Which theater is that happening now? Which theater?
We're going up the law school now. Now, what they did in the law school, they built it, that's a new building, if you know it.
Yeah, I know it, man. I'm talking there already.
Right, and it have a lecture room, too, which is set for the young lawyers to practice court in it.
Yes.
So we're going into a lecture theater designed for a courtroom, and that's very good. At 200 seats.
Yes.
And, you know, the crowd, we can manage the crowd that will come to see this trial.
Yes.
So that's where we have it up. UWI, lecture room 2, Faculty of Law. He just go on the Ring Road. You can't miss it when you go on the Ring Road.
Like
opposite
to
Norman Manley Law School.
Like
you
go back to the hospital. Like you go back to the hospital.
Right. In fact, it's nearer to the hospital than the state wing of the hospital and others. So if you go pop in, you can walk through the hospital and come down.
Yeah.
Come down to the Faculty of Law. Next door, the Faculty of Medicine.
All right. So the question is now, what going to be different apart from the venue? What going to be different?
Well, you like when we talk out the thing.
What do you mean,
you,
man,
you bring me on to talk out the things.
Yeah, man, you have to tell me what's different, man.
But you are different.
Maybe we'll let go here this time.
No, well, the jury in a bridge, I'm in a business with me. Can't interfere the jury in a motor. The jury may pick from the audience, too, you know. And you know, it is wrong to interfere with a jury, but I'm going to tell you, motor. We find a witness who did serve food in a governor here. House.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, but I'm not saying nothing more. And witness come forward. Yeah, then of course, governor, you fire him, man, and we have him. Him come and testify, you know, him or talk the things, you know, but don't push me too far. What want to the suspense?
So
a new witness has been found.
So let me ask you now, where the witness is there all the while?
Well, him did afraid. Him in a witness protection. Him did afraid for come out of St. Thomas, but him a come at St. Andrew.
Oh.
You laugh about that. You don't know, so we have governor here in custody now. Him in a jail right now, you know, governor here, you know.
So
to face trial Saturday night, you know.
It's so like when you bribe a man, you know.
No, Virgin, him in a jail. We have him.
No,
we have him.
We
have him. He was trying to leave, you know. He was trying to leave the island. And, you know, the revolution go down, and we grab him and carry him for trial.
Okay.
Yes. So and what's new again?
No. Yeah, tell me what's new again, tonight.
Well, you know, say in them time is fear, man is judge, but it's a woman going to be the judge this time.
So it's a wrong sentence. It go on in a sentence.
No. No. If ask for a retrial, you know, him say he want to try and send Thomas. Him don't want to try and send Thomas.
And him don't want a man try him?
Right, and them don't want him to, because the people for St. Thomas don't like him. So we say, all right, come, we're going to St. Andrew. So down there, we're carrying for trial now.
So in the original case,
yes,
a woman was part of the judgment,
No, remember, it's a jury going to try him, you know, but it's the judge in charge at the courtroom.
So what
there's 12 people going to try.
Balance history, I don't understand.
It's all right, we just say, you know, sometimes the judge changes. And
no,
see him justice.
Behave yourself, man. When I try balance history, me laugh.
It look like if you know, say, them fighting two man, them from take leadership roles, them time there.
It's a guilt trip, man. It's a guilt trip. When you do a man the other day, and the man bring on a guilt trip, man, and say, when you do a woman, because maybe him can penetrate the woman easier.
Make him try, look. He might be the same lawyer, do, but we get another prosecutor now, too. That's what's different. Another prosecutor coming to him.
So, two prosecutors against the one in the Finland?
But the other prosecutor did have to leave the island. So, him under protection. You know, so, we have this new prosecutor.
Too. So, them buy him out, too?
No, them can't do that. Well, that much time you have with me. Because I'm going away, them can't get the ticket and all them things there.
No, behave yourself, no, man. I'm here around the ticket, man. Behave yourself, but that's my program, man. You have time, man. I want to know what is different with this. Why you don't tell me two things, you know?
Yes.
Just tell me, say, they have a woman judge now.
Yeah.
And you have two prosecutors now.
A new prosecutor.
Yeah, so you see, it's a whole heap of things before we talk about which part is something I keep. So what else is new again?
Well, you know, say, a woman when they get sentenced 20 years, she, their GP, they might bring her come Saturday night, come
she
testify
the
against
the
him, because
one.
She's the only one. You did hear already, man, the feisty one, when you tell her.
And she did throw the first one?
Yeah, man, she no play, man. Them say she threw it. You don't, Bridget, don't, you're in farmer, man.
Well, you know, the government say, if we know what we know, we must tell.
Yeah, you go and talk, you see, you go on.
All right, so she got do one now. Different. What different?
I bring her from GP to come testify, and she's the only one who can say how the court martial set up to show them how the injustice go on
in there. Yeah.
Yes.
All right, so you set up at the faculty, the law faculty.
Law faculty, Mona, you take a bus, go Ligani, and then you go up to UA, and you drive, go along the dam, the Mona Road, underneath the. You know, and go to the dam and go in at the university. But you remember, say, Mona campus is a old sugar estate, you know.
Of course. Of course.
Yeah, it was a whole sugar estate. We can't get it from them, you know. Them have way away, but we still amount a trial upon them.
And over the other side of the road is a whole aqueduct too.
Yes, the whole aqueduct. So we can't, all those who want to forget, say, we did under slavery.
Yeah.
It, right up at the campus, there's a whole estate old where we used to.
Yeah, whole slavery land, capital land. All right, when is this happening now? Tell me when it happened.
Well, what we do now, we bring it in a town now. We're going to give the people in Kingston and St. Andrew and all over Jamaica six showing. Them can't say we don't give them enough.
That's serious?
It's going to be 3 weekends, starting this weekend. Okay. Saturday, Sunday, 3rd and 4th of December. The next Saturday and Sunday, 10th and 11th of December. And finally, 17th and 18th of December. 3 straight weekends. So all the school children, when holiday finish, you have no excuse, you can come watch it. All the law students, all the people who love history, all the people who say them don't want other people write our history, is we write it now, Muta. We are write it now.
Yes. So, you don't have no matinee performance for people who don't want
to stay on Sunday afternoon, that's enough. I don't know, you have to go in early, you get beaten, Muta. You have to go in early. You come 6 o'clock, by 8 o'clock it finished, sir.
Okay. And the money, how much of charge for going at this time?
Oh, we do a deal for the students, but they must have ID. And one ID, one ticket, $500 for the students. Yeah. They get a $1,000 rebate because the tickets cost $1,500. Okay. Students with ID, $500.
They're supposed to appear a student in there for the 6th time it show.
Education. The young, more important than me, you know. We not the departure law.
No, man, talk for yourself. Oi, attorney at law, talk for yourself. Talk to me about we. Which we? What you talking about, man? We don't departure law.
So you don't want to know where them can get the tickets now? You ready for that?
Yeah, man. That's how we are reach, man.
There are five places where you can get it. The first place you can get it from is my office at Ford U Street. All the people downtown, there are two downtown distribution center. My office at 4 Duke Street, Pan Duke Street, just below Victoria Mutual. Or you can go over to 79 King Street, which is Liberty Hall.
Yes.
Liberty Hall have the tickets for you, ready and willing to sell you. So that's two downtown locations. And we have one in New Kingston, which is 2 Trafalgar Road, which is Cafe Africa.
Yes.
Cafe Africa,
okay.
Trafalgar Road, Kingston 5. That near to where, Muta, you know them places.
Steve Golden players.
Africa. Yeah. Then we have two last one. You can get it at Institute of Gender and Development Studies over the new section, the new building up on you with it, on the right hand side going up. And that is at the Gender and Development Studies over the regional headquarters.
Yeah.
And finally, guess who is on board now? Fontana Pharmacy.
Okay.
And anywhere else along island wide, you can get to the Fontana Pharmacy, which is at Barbican Square up at East King's House Road.
Yes. All right.
But then people who want to hear more telephone numbers, of checkout tickets, they can check it at. These are the telephone numbers. The first one you can get it is 337-1622 and 927-1913.
Okay.
Let me repeat that. 337-1622 and 927-1913.
Okay.
You don't want to hear who sponsored this, man. Who is behind this? It was sponsored by the Institute of Gender Studies, regional, and the Faculty of Law, Dean Jackson. When I went to him and said, you know, we can't get this space, how much you charge? He said, no, man. The Faculty of Law is with open arms embrace the trial of governor here. So the Faculty of Law is part of the big sponsor of this event. I will respect that.
Yes.
It is endorsed by the National Council on Reparation.
Okay.
You get everything, anything else, Muta?
Who is the director and who are the actors?
Hey, Muta, the last time you say I want to run out of here with the player, go out of there. But the people them know, say, it move, you know, you there, you know.
Look here, the attorney at law will not, it not encourage me to tell lie to the public. I refuse.
Yes, man, it touch your Muta, man. Tell the people, say it touch your Muta.
I refuse to be coaxed by a liar.
Muta, which one of the actress them did reach you? Bogle mother, garden wife, which one of them? Talawa. That I will lick your man. Yeah, oh, man. She taught the pigs. Make the people come and see Talawa talk, man. The survivor. She's one of the survivors, you know? Will you ask me again, my brother?
No, I am asking you, the director. Is I know he's used a writer.
Yes, but my disrespect, Mr. Michael Holgate, who nice it up and make sure it run the right way. No respect to Holgate. And you know him, he's a Pan-Africanist like we.
He's
not just a marriage draw now for him artistic thing, of him devotion to the thing, and him really lift it way above. And don't forget Professor Verin Shepherd, who is, you know, what we call the executive producer. And she touch it up now and make sure the historical parts of it are true. Because, Muta, we use back the names of the people, you know. You see, Governor Ayers' lawyer, is his name is the same name that I'd use. Yeah. You see, Talawa, she have the same name of a woman who was in prison.
Yeah, you know, protect no innocent.
So it's educational, it's historically educational. The people who are doing CAPE and CXC, the students, if you come and you get a question on the Marbury Rebellion, it's like, hey, you're going to get on that question because it is accurate.
Yeah,
then the lawyers and the law students, I use my 36 years in the courtroom and make sure I say it is legally accurate. So it's a learning event.
All right, so Mark, the last question I'm going to ask you now.
Yeah.
When we are going to do Sam Sharp?
Now, the man them commissioned me for write that one, sir.
Oh, yeah?
If the people support this one, I will do the Sam Sharp trial. Because Daddy Sam is, Daddy Sam get a rough time in the courtroom.
May I tell you?
And get a rough time. And, you know, I can't imagine if Daddy Sam thing did succeed.
May I tell you?
Hello, Jamaica, run different.
Totally different. All right, Regine, well, we give thanks. You know, we give thanks and we say, all the people them come out three different weekends, you say.
Yes.
Three different weekends at the faculty, law faculty and the university campus.
Yeah, my brother. And I remember now, Muta, met the people know is a 1,000 house governor here in Georgia, Bundung, you know, and a 439 people in kill. So it was no joking. When last 400 people did one time in Jamaica, this event is serious, you know. Yeah. I tell you, but we give thanks to IRFM, who is also a person who always follow up the thing.
All right.
It's out there. Respect to you, Muta. Yeah, respect to man. Kabu and all the warriors.
Blessed man. Give thanks, brethren. Give thanks.
Bless up, my brother.
Yeah, that was Bert Samuel, attorney at law. He's the writer for this, the trial of Governor here. I tell you, you don't want to miss it. For those of you who never go take the journey to Morant Bay last year, you need to go to the faculty, the law faculty at the University of the West Indies, for really see this thing. It's amazing. It's amazing. And as you hear the man say, it is an accurate depiction of history. This is the stepping razor. You're on the stepping razor, the art of war. We want to, for those of you who didn't know, there has been a Rastafari exhibition at the Institute of Jamaica for the past 3 years. Yes, you heard me right. 3 years. That Rastafari exhibition is a very comprehensive look at Rastafari through the ages, since the time of its inception in the 1930s. Well, this exhibition will be closed on Sunday. This Sunday, and there will be a closing ceremony taking place at the Institute. So for those of you who can make it there this Sunday, The Rastafari exhibition, which has been at the Institute for 3 years, will close this Sunday. This Sunday. Very, very serious exhibition that was taking place there. What is happening here? Okay. Not moving. Okay. This is the stepping razor. You know, we're going to talk to a brethren who has spent a lot of time dealing with the people in Tivoli Garden as it relates to the justice that is supposed to be meted out to them after that government atrocity that was done to the people of Tivoli Garden. So we want to talk to him about what is really happening, because we hear about this inquiry and we hear to them come to them conclusion, and we don't hear nothing. I go on the other day with a sleep on TV, live on TV, PP clock all the way with a keep up with it. No, we're not here, Nata. All right, we're not saying Nata whatsoever, I will say. But plus, we want to remind the government about Tivoli Gardens. We definitely want to remind the government about Tivoli and what was said by Chucky. Chucky 1, 2, and 3. That is a serious thing. Chucky come on the radio and say certain things, you know, we want to find out what is happening. If it's a scare tactic, somebody use like Chucky the Dolly, you understand? I'm afraid of that Dolly there, you know. Tell me your man named Chuck. May I say, all right. But we want to find out what is going on with that. But we're going to connect with Lydia Aguilar. But before that, the election will just pass, yeah. I mean, really and truly, you know, I have to do some calculation. So I wonder if any one of the man beside me can calculate 30% of 1,849,012. John, suppose you can do that, you know. I mean, young, when I say John, young. Give me a 30% of this thing, yeah. Believe you me, because something wrong. Because I am told that 30% of the electorates who is registered to elect to vote. It's 30% vote. That is what I'm saying, Bridget. 30% vote.
Yeah, 30% then.
So this is 30% of that. Mm-hmm. 554,703 people vote. That means 1,300,000 people no vote. Some can go so. No, serious. You never vote, Bridget? Why you don't vote?
No, vote.
You don't have a vote, I don't have a finger.
No ID.
Young, you vote?
No.
That is, we are going to Jamaica. We are not responsible citizens. We must deal with the right to vote, man.
You vote?
Me? Me not a responsible citizen. Me not a responsible citizen. Me is an irresponsible citizen. Believe you be. All right. No, the GLP now sweep everything now. Them have the council them that means that they're responsible for the road them. The GLP government responsible for the road them. And them did responsible for it before, you know. But they're more responsible for it now. You know, Mel Bridget, who want you up? Why up Johnny Black, you know? Believe you be why up Johnny Black. We up not the James Bond, you know, Johnny Black. I hear Johnny Black say be the minister of roads. But you know, if you have an election where 1,849,000 people supposed to vote, and not even 50% of them vote, cause to me, you know, if 50% vote that bad, you know, if 50% vote that bad, it means that 1 million and something people don't vote and you win the election. We won't really feel so good still, you know. Never did evil have no register, which is the majority of the Jamaican people, never vote. So, I would have feel funny. I mean, I would have glad to say I win still. But me, that feel funny. But if me lose now, right, I would have pack up. Yeah, if me lose an election like this where only 30% of the people them vote, trust me, man. Me go. As a matter of fact, me could have go to St. Elizabeth and build a wall. Yes, because this is serious. 30% of the people them vote in an election. Are the lowest turnout ever happening in an election? Young, tell me.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I really know about these things. Are the lowest turnout in any election? 30% of the people them vote. That means that there's something intrinsically wrong with how the people them view the two party them, you know. It's like how the people them view Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton. Them don't know which one to vote for, you know, because they said the choice is not a good choice between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. Well, apparently now, we have the same thing going on in Jamaica. The choice is not a good choice between the PNP and the GLP. So the electorate stay home And those who could have said, boy, I make a go vote now, decide say, them still not vote. So the majority of Jamaican people don't vote. I mean, you have to look upon that, you know, politician. You have to really take a stock. You have to take a stock. When the majority of Jamaican people don't find, you know, interested enough to do certain things, something's intrinsically wrong. You can't just go and see why you win, so, and you get the mandate to don't fix the road them again. And you have new mayor now of Kingston. And when we look on the road them, so who responsible for Mantigo? Who responsible for which sentence? So? Who responsible for it? You know the name of the person responsible for sentence? I mean, Ocherius, that's all now. Ocherius. Who responsible for the road between the gas station and down at the square? Who responsible for that?
Councillor Ademir.
What name?
Councillor Ademir. Which one
of them? The two of them. Because if I'm going to talk with them, I'm going to say I don't feel responsibility.
But all of that change over now.
Change over to what?
Yeah, from PNP to Labour right now.
Yeah, but who now responsible for the road now? Because the PNP never have fixed the road. So now we have a next one now for go fix the road. What name? We don't know the name. I wonder if Shamara can find the name of that man there. Because really and truly now. Eh?
Ben Davis is responsible for Ochi now.
Ben Davis responsible for Ochi.
He's
the councillor. Mm. What councillor supposed to do? Look about road and infrastructure and all them something there. Make sure say the taxi man them park properly. Don't there and block up the road when people want to move. And obey the stoplight. And make sure say, the police them have zero tolerance for certain things. All right. May I tell the councillor, say, councillor, me know you're not going to tell me, say, you don't have no money. But if you want the country to be a proper running thing, you must have transportation in order in which people can move to and fro without having to pay thousands of dollars for fit them front end, for patch them tire every time they go down the road. Because me, I drive with the bridge and I go down the road. You understand? You know, so I can't mash up. Right off. All right. So, me have to drive now like how you drive. Commoners. How to drive. What you know? The mountain. A country, between IRFM and God only say, you know, account, how much time I have to go serve out that hole, you know. And everybody knows which part the next hole there, you know. I say, boy, you want to say hole there? I say, yeah, a new one, nobody say, you know. I drive with Tupac last night, you know. Tupac say, yeah, all right, wait till you reach down there, so you're going to see a big hole down there, so. I tell you, that's that. No, when it reaches stage that people are drive. And if you check all, you'll know the country gone. Yeah, man. If you cannot drive on road and if you figure out which part of the next hole there, it's terrible. So I don't know what the council can do for Jamaican people. I mean, Ocherius people. Because I never go talk about my area now, you know. I never go talk about through the junction, you know. Because trust me, look more, I just ask some buggy we have to go use. And donkey. We have to go carry donkey, go through the so. May I ask the Chinese people them to load the donkey them? Because we soon need the donkey them because we can't afford for bad drive on the highway. When the highway costs too much. So load the donkey them, that's we can go back to donkey. Because that's how we are going to reach us now. And that's how we are reach us now. Because the road them now fixed. And if you get up one morning and block the road, you say you do something unlawful. And the councillor them and the people them who are responsible not fixing the road. So what you want the people them to do? And now them build a highway, we're supposed to move goods and services easier and quicker. That means the cost of goods and production is supposed to be less. And we see it increase because the man has said, well, I'm going to pay $2,000 to go through the boat, the toll. So I'm going to raise that now to make that, compensate for that $2,000. I mean, I want to drive through the junction. But now, as me, I say, I'm going to use horse and buggy, a donkey. So I ask the people who are killing the donkey them and sell it as meat. I mean, I spread no propaganda. I have pictures for sure. me have live pictures for sure that you have a group of people in Jamaica who's killing donkey rapid and I sell them as meat, beef, steak. Watch what you're eating in your party. Watch what you're eating in your party. I know nothing wrong with donkey meat, you know, because if you eat pig, you must can't eat donkey. Really. Anybody when you have pig, suppose you can't have a dog, though. It's just simple, because, I mean, what's the difference? One more effect, dangerous still, the pig. No matter how you grow up the pig more dangerous than if you grow up your dog. It's just that because you domesticate the dog. No one wants to kill them dog and eat them. You know, see, and if a man next door, you feel say your dog and get trouble, and you don't see your dog, the possibility that he has ate it is really, really something that we have to start checking now, because the way Jamaica run now, we are going to have dog supper. And the dog is going to have our supper again. And we are going to have dog supper, you know. And the matter of fact, we are going to have the dog for supper. And they said, Richard, you know. Because my mother used to say, you're going to have dog supper, eh? We might have dog for supper now. So I am asking, I am pleading, the counselors who now claim, say, them have the mandate to make the thing work properly now. We ask them to situate that the road, every week me have a company, you know. I mean, now come out fight, you know. The road them need instant priority fixing. Because, me I tell you, me don't know if them people that drive on road, Rasta. Because the other day, I come in and I say, wait, you know, see, I go buy a helicopter. Yeah, man, I go buy a helicopter. But then again, you know, them people are so mad, you know, that you will fly out the helicopter, them do something to the atmosphere, they will make the helicopter crash, you know. Believe you me. I don't put it bounce them, you know. You could have said, boy, all right, now, I'm going to get an overcraft. Jamaican people don't know when them overcraft, you know. But them have some things named overcraft, you know, not touch the ground. When it's moving, it come off a ear, you know. You really and truly, we could have to go and figure that out. Because, obviously, these people can't make road. And obviously, when they make the road, they don't service the road. And obviously, people, it calls people, I'm sorry if you're a taxi man, you know. I'm sorry if you're a taxi man, you know, brethren. Because it's a taxi man, we are going to see him road two and fro. And if you dodge all them old there, sometimes he might move so that he might go look a little bread quick. He can't remember say, the old up the road there, so. Because nowadays you can't hide. Watch out. Me I drive on a bus yesterday, you know. One of them not so the express bus, you know. And me I tell you, you know, when me look on the road, you know, me say, you know, say that man you can't go around that old, yeah. And me realize him can't go around the old, you know. And him just take him go like about 1 mile per hour. And it's when I'm going on at the wall, the people at the boat, hear the people at the boat, the people, I'm like, it's like, I wonder if I'm going to come out of that wall here. Believe you be, but I understand this thing here. So, counselors, and who feels, who get a mandate now with 30% of the people vote. 30% of the people them vote, but some of them vote for one or the other party. So it's not like the 30% vote for one party. That's all? 30% vote means, say, yeah, so one get like 20-odd%. And one get the other race or something like that. Oh my gosh, man. So if you I couldn't proud of that. If me decide to make a keep a session, if me I keep a session now, see? And we give out 100 invitation. And between me and you, and 30 people come. And we provide food, $600 million for go buy vote. Yes, me, you know, at 30%, at 30 people come at the party, you know. Me can't say that party there a good thing. Me can't say that party there a good thing at all. So me don't know what the council them are going to do about it. Because me indict them right on a program, you know. Believe you me. Me indict them on the program because the road them can't stay so rasta. The road them cannot stay so. Cannot stay that way there. It has caused too much grief from people who continuously use it. Grief it has caused. All right. we're going to take this ad and come to Lloyd Aguila. Like it, what I have?
Hello?
Yes, Lloyd.
Yes.
You're there, how are you now?
I'm here, man.
All right. We know, so you're the convener of the Tivoli Committee, human rights activist, and you also make short movies.
Yes, documentaries.
Documentaries. Okay, yeah, all right. In point of case, I know, because it's apparently that them while the people them forget where happened on at Tivoli Yard. So everything is at a lull now. What is really happening with this thing here? What is really happening?
All right, Muta. The inquiry made a recommendation that the people should be compensated. The government decided that, yes, okay, we accept this recommendation, we're going to compensate the people. They then set up a compensation committee. And this compensation committee, finally, we know who the chairman is. The chairman is a former, a retired chairman of the Court of Appeal, Mr. Panton. And they appointed two pastors to assist him with it. They are now saying that the people must submit their claims by December 5th, which I understand is Monday. But there's a whole heap of confusion about this, Muta, because they are saying that the chairman is saying of the committee, saying no honor dramatics inside there. What he means by that, I have no idea. But in the honor dramatics, so the public can't come and the media cannot come. We don't know what his terms of reference is, and so it's only the people them who are victims who can come. But the people them must bring them lawyer. Now, it is not clear whether the
why the people them must bring lawyer? Why they must bring lawyer?
That's a good question, because the chairman says, Mr. Panton said, that it is not a court of law. It's not court. It's not a trial. So why you need a lawyer, I don't know. Because the chairman knows very well that in a court, you are entitled, it's a constitutional right to represent yourself.
Yeah, so who asked him why them need a lawyer? Anybody did ask him why them need a lawyer?
Well, Muta, on behalf of the Tivoli Committee, I have written at least two letters to Mr. Panton. And all he has written back to me to say, not him, but the office, he said, we received your letters, and the man has not paid me the courtesy of responding to me.
All right, hold on, the Aguila. In the letter, you didn't ask him why the people them need a lawyer. I just write
of
to
course,
him generally. Oh, you
course.
Asked him. Okay.
Yeah, man. I told the argument I just made to you a while ago. I said, it's a constitutional right to represent yourself in court. So therefore, why do you have to stipulate that people need a lawyer to come before you? Your man don't need a lawyer. Just come and say, boy, such a thing happened to me. These are my bills, expenses, whatever. If a man wants to have a lawyer, that's fine, no problem. But what is happening now is that by insisting that people can only come before them with a lawyer, they are setting up to disenfranchise hundreds of people, because the public defender is not very clear, very straightforward as to whether they will be representing people or not. So you have a lot of confusion now in Tivoli Gardens and all over the place where people are concerned. Who defending them? How they're going to be defended? Will they be called? Has their name been submitted? Did they fall through the cracks? Etc. I mean, it's a shame, it's a disgrace that you have the compensation committee and the public defender treating the people and victimizing them one more time again. It is really, really sad.
All right, so what is it about it? All right, what is it that the people them saying directly in Tivoli Yard? What them saying?
Well, I mean, you have all categories of damages and of down there. You have people who lost their loved ones. Those people have to be compensated. The soldier and police come into people's house and mash up them house, mash up them fridge, them stove, them settee, them roof, them all those kind of things. Those people have to be compensated. They went around to Chang Avenue and they went around to Mackenzie Drive and they burned down people's houses. They give them a little $250,000, which can buy a couple bag of cement, right? And they're acting as if the Carter gave them $250,000, which was not compensation. They call it a compassionate grant. It looked like them don't want to give them no more money. And
how much people them get the $250,000 to?
I beg your pardon?
How much people got the $250,000?
I have a list here. I didn't really count. It's about 90 people, I think.
Wait. 90 people get $250,000.
For the house bond up, totally bond up.
No, each are one.
No, man, each person
get $250,000.
Right. That came from some guy here. Them describe what was inside them house.
Yeah.
$250,000 can replace what was burned
out. Four furniture can reach $250,000.
It's monkey money. And sometimes they mash up a man fridge and stove and then give them $15,000.
I was
down there some months ago and I met a poor little old lady, two old ladies. And them said, boy, from them mash up them stove and them fridge. She down the fridge and stove in her house.
She
doesn't know if she will be called. The public defender, instead of putting on their website the names of the people who have been submitted, they haven't done that. Mm. They're just so wishy-washy, and people go down there and they might cuss and a trace and all kind of something, are treating poor people in the most disgraceful way.
Right,
so what is happening is that these people are going to be victimized a second time around.
All right, so what will happen after the 5th now? What, because them get a lifeline and also the 5th is really what's supposed to happen. Well,
that is it. If you don't submit your claim by the 5th, right, then you there's no guarantee that you will ever be compensated, because that's a cutoff point. Now, if you didn't have this lawyer business, a man can just write a statement and carry it to the committee and give it to them and say, well, all right, this is my claim, this is my phone number, this is how you contact me. When the time comes, you call me. But you can't even do that because you don't have no lawyer. You don't know if the public defender is properly defending you.
Yeah.
And there is a private lawyer that is trying to represent people, but they want one-third of whatever you get. So some people don't really want to go that route because, you know, it's a little money them go and get and they don't want to give up one third of it.
There's
a heap of confusion down there, Muta, may I tell you. It's a disgrace, and they are victimizing poor people a second time around.
All right, so what are you, now, as a man who is deeply involved with this thing, What suggestion should I do now, Muta?
I say to people, I want to go to the public defender. I want to ask her, looking her in her face, I want to say to her, are you defending me or not? Did my claim go up to the committee? And I'm telling you, the public defender has been unable to give people a clear answer, right? So total confusion with that concern.
Yeah.
No, I am not a liar, so I can't defend the people the way in which I would like to defend them.
I
think that the dramatics was directed at me. It's like, they don't want me involved in this thing at all. All right, fine. So I said to the people then, if you can't hear from the public defender, go and get a lawyer, right? But you see, the public defender is not clear and transparent in communicating with people, so there's confusion. But let me tell you one thing, though, Muta. I am particularly interested in the thousands of young men who were detained, because the report said that their constitutional rights were violated. In other words, you can't just go and drape up a man and detain him without probable cause and without explaining to him why you're detaining him. And hundreds, if not thousands, of young men were detained.
Without any explanation.
Yeah, without an explanation, and the committee ruled that. So I am particularly interested in some of those guys, and I've been going after them, and I said, listen, one way or another, you fill out the form, you put down your name, we'll carry it to the compensation committee on Monday, and if we have to file a lawsuit in court to have an injunction to stop the proceedings so that the thing can be operated properly, so that people know, you know, that they have a claim. Those young men have a claim, and the public defender doesn't seem to be interested in them. Nobody is interested in them at all. So, I mean, left, right, and center is pure second round of victimization that is going on amongst these people.
Yes.
It's unfortunate. Very bad.
And this is after millions of dollars was spent to reach to a conclusion And it still don't conclude it as yet.
It don't conclude. Plus the Prime Minister don't apologize yet, you know. No, he not make the apology yet. So the committee, when they're looking into compensation, the Prime Minister has said, well, what we are apologizing for. So you need that kind of apology for a framework within which to decide what happened to the people then. You understand? Yeah, so he is very conveniently and very nimbly not apologize to the people and yet. So that is part of the further confusion.
Yeah, well, Bridget, we're going to just keep open eye and see what is really going to happen, because as we say again, we don't want to keep balling and say nothing now come out tight, because something has to come out tight.
Something has to come out tight, man, and people have to wake up because we have been lulled to sleep because they said they're going to compensate. So people believe that everything is nice, but everything is not nice.
No,
one more thing I want to say, Mota, is that, as you know, this report never held nobody criminally liable for all the for people and were killed. And the terrorism, that's what we call them, the terrorist action which were taken against the people. They didn't recommend criminal charges against anybody.
None at all.
Well, if you read the head of Indicom has recently said that private citizens have the right to bring private prosecution against people. And so what the Tivoli Committee is planning to do is to bring a private prosecution against the three superior commanders of the operation, the former Prime Minister, Mr. Golden, the former head of the Jamaica Constabulary Force, Mr. Ellington, and the former head of the Jamaica Defense Force, Mr. Stuart, Major General Stuart Saunders. We are in the process of preparing, and we're going to go before the courts, and we're going to lay the case, and we're going to lay the evidence, and we're going to say we have the right to call for a private prosecution of these individuals, that they must answer to the charge of terrorism. Because we have a Terrorism Prevention Act. And that Terrorism Prevention Act says that if the state conducts a military operation and doesn't conform to international law, and we have to abide by international law, then that is a terrorist act. And that is the only way we see now how we could possibly bring these people to book before the court for the crimes that were committed against the people in Tivoli Gardens. So I'm hoping that people will support us and you will understand that the public defense, I'm sorry, the DPP has the power to shut us down, right?
Yes.
I am hoping that they allowed Booth Stewart and Sanders and ATL to prosecute employees for fraud. So they will not now show class bias and allow the people themselves to sue, and not to sue, but to criminally charge a government that violated their human rights. So I hope that
you even give it
to one side, they must give it to the other side, and allow us to prosecute these people for terrorism and crimes against humanity.
All right, Bridget. Give thanks, Bridget. We'll keep in contact.
Hello?
Yeah, we'll keep in contact.
Yes.
No, we'll say give thanks. We're going to keep the line open and keep in contact with you. Okay, now you hear me? Okay. That was Lydie Aguilar. He very ardently struggling for the people in Tivoli Garden and very concerned about it. I mean, like most of us should be concerned about it. Talking of concerns, you know, we have a concern that said we hear certain things that take place and we are one less, we are going.
No, I mean, we had an ad hoc committee of parliament, you know, that sat and, in fact, have signed off. And we have made the recommendations, and those recommendations have come to cabinet. And cabinet, to the best of my knowledge, have signed off, though we have not specific action. Mm-hmm. But one of them, for example, is the amount of compensation that should be put in the fund for the victims
survivors
and their relatives.
Yeah.
That amount has not been declared by cabinet as yet, but I can assure you that the apology for the Carr Gardens not only was it recommended by the public defender, but it will be delivered by the Prime Minister at a suitable time.
Mm-hmm.
And that again could be in a matter of weeks.
You're saying an apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister?
That is correct.
That's what you're saying, Minister?
Yes, yes, yes. An apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister on behalf of the government of Jamaica, as recommended by the public defender.
All right, and we should see that, you're saying, in the coming weeks.
In the coming weeks, okay.
Okay. We are dealing with two things, guys. A double thing we are dealing with now. You understand? Because this committee from what was an incident happening in Jamaica 2010 because of one man who was not criminally charged in Jamaica. I never have no criminal thing going on in Jamaica, but the American government did want him. And this alone created a confusion, death and destruction in a little bit of area in a Jamaica named Tivoli Garden. The government decided to go get a committee. They send go for a Bajan man, pay him several million dollars for run a thing to figure out what the conclusion is supposed to come to. They come to a conclusion, say, nobody from the government side, the police side, or the soldier side is criminally responsible for anything. But, them feel like the people them should be compensated. Okay. Switch back to 50 years ago. And we're going to come back with it, the 50 years ago thing. Click it. Okay. So a while ago, we was talking to Light de Aguilar, representing Tivoligan people them. And we just say, oh, the government create a committee to look into the devastation that took place. And the committee come to a conclusion that the people there must be compensated for a lot of the damages that was done there. Okay. So we switch back now to 50 years ago when the atrocity against Rastafari movement was done by the said party in power, said government, different players, but the same government, same Jamaica Labour Party, you know. And what happened is that we were listening to Cabo program from October the 16th, October to November, November, to nearly 1.5 months now. Minister of Justice, Delroy Chuck, was talking from Cabo program. And the argument about the Carroll Garden incident come up. And the minister categorically tell Jamaican people, say, the Prime Minister is expected to and will issue an apology in coming weeks to the survivors of the Carroll Garden massacre. No, I don't know what them people are saying coming weeks, what they mean, you know. But I am not going to interpret coming weeks can mean, say, we have to wait till the next Carroll Garden incident happen. Maybe 10 years' time, and then we apologize to the first Carroll Garden incident. I don't know. Because now them come to a conclusion that the people they must be compensated for the atrocity in Tivoli Gardens. And now we say them are lagger, 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 lagger. So for those of you who don't believe what I was saying, I'm going to play about this clip from Cabo program, the Running African Forum, that was aired on October the 16th. We want to play it back. I can see if I can find it here. Yeah. All right.
No, no, I mean, we had an ad hoc committee of parliament, you know, that sat and, in fact, have signed off. And we have made the recommendations, and those recommendations have come to cabinet. And cabinet, to the best of my knowledge, have signed off, though we have not recommended specific action. Mm-hmm. But one of them, for example, is the amount of compensation that should be put in the fund for the victims, survivors, and their relatives.
Yeah.
That amount has not been declared by cabinet as yet, but I can assure you that the apology for the Carroll Gardens not only was it recommended by the public defender, but it will be delivered by the Prime Minister at a suitable time.
Mm-hmm.
And that again could be in a matter of weeks.
You're saying an apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister?
Not as frank.
That's what you're saying, Minister?
Yes, yes, yes. An apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister on behalf of the government of Jamaica, as recommended by the public defender.
All right, and we should see that, you're saying, in the coming weeks?
In the coming weeks, okay.
All right. That was Chucky talking. I am very scared. And I have a right to be scared because this is the present Minister of Justice speaking on behalf of the Prime Minister. Now, Mr. Every time I talk about this man, I forget his name, you know. Well, what bridge name, Minister, the roadman, they were saying, I bring back the train thing again. What name again? What name again? Him I bring back the train thing, man. and Mike Henry. Why I'm a bridge, you know. Oh, me, I forget my bridge name. Mike Henry, over the years, have publicly on forums apologized to the Rastafari community for the atrocity that was done against the Rastafari community in 1963. But he said that he cannot speak on behalf of his party or the government. But he did apologize as an individual person. And we appreciate that very much. Now we hear this man now, the Minister of Justice, say, from October, you know, that's why I say I don't want to interview a politician. I don't want, because politicians always tell you what you want to hear. I don't want to, and I know a couple of them will respect what I say when I say, I don't want to interview no politician. Because if you talk to a politician, I'm going to tell you the nicest thing them, and you're going to say, okay, see that? Them are going to apologize in a couple of weeks. This is nearly 2 months gone now. And I don't understand what it means when I say in the coming weeks. What does someone mean when they say, I'm going to apologize to you in the coming days? It means that all 500 years from now, him can't don't apologize, you know. And not only that, because sometimes you wait, you're there half a tree, you know, and you wait for a man, you know, and him say, me de pa me way, man. Me soon come. And him good at the other man to go be, you know. And you there half a tree, wait for the man and say, how far you reach, man? Him say, me soon come, man. Me de pa me rear. And him good at the other watch you else, and de pa me way. Now, it's a similar thing with Chucky. We don't have no lucky with Chucky because watch you know. He must say in the coming weeks, the Prime Minister is expected to make and will issue an apology in the coming weeks to the survivors of the Carroll Guard massacre. How much weeks gone, Reginald Sistrin? How much weeks gone? 50 odd years. A whole heap of the people them who was devastated and displaced by this atrocity by the government of Jamaica against the people of Jamaica. And then come back again in 2010 and devastate the same government by the government of the people in Tivoli Garden. Where is the justice? Because the public defender don't recommend certain things. Both to the Tivoli Garden, and to the Carroll Garden incident. So we don't know. I wonder if the police them and decide say them are gonna go up a Cherry Garden next and burn down some people and shoot up the place and ransack people place and everything there. How long them are gonna take to compensate these people in Garden, Cherry Garden. We shouldn't ever think that because they're not going to do that. They make a respectable knock at the gate. Excuse me, sir. Is Mr. John Jones there, please? Can I speak to him? And they never use the time. Let him go get up here. Hey, boy. You know, let me look for you. Come out of the house. Me want to know when this man say in the coming weeks, 6 weeks ago, him say in the coming weeks. What he mean when him say in the coming weeks? Because when me hear him say, you know, me say, see there, in the coming weeks. And that me say, from his EM say, you know, say in the coming weeks, you know, say in the coming weeks can mean all 52 week. Wow. And then now we have the Tivoli Garden, we have the Carroll Garden. What other more incident? This government, the Jamaica Labour Party government, what are they going to conjure up now? Because given that them can't control crime in Jamaica, and the Prime Minister, St. Andrew of the Holy One, say that if them was in power, you could have leave your door open. Who remember that statement? Who remember the statement we say? It's because every time the PNP in power, the crime rate gone up. And if when them go in power, you can't leave your door open. How much people are sleep with them door open? Some people wake up and don't see the door. And then they close it. So, me don't understand. Me don't know what happened now. Me don't know. Because we can't make them forget this thing. It seems we have one head of police say, Vibes Cartel is fingered in 100 more murders. My God, man. That you, that terrible man. It looks like you're going to try to wipe out the world of Jamaica. Because if the head of the police can come out and tell you, say, pan national TV, say, this man will help for murder, him is fingered in 100 more murders. From the time when him say it until now, me no hear nothing more about them. You know that means, say, you see them 100 people who get murdered according to him, the family, if this is true, you know, can you imagine what the family of the murdered, of the victims are going through for no say them loved one die and there's no justice for their loved ones? When this man, no say, according to him, because he come from public TV and said, him no say 100 other people out there get murdered. And me no say them, so according to him, Bishop Alpha Wema said, me know said those 100 people supposed to have families, mothers, girlfriend, and children. So if him know that, why make the families of these people suffering like that? And him don't come forward with the evidence and the proof that this youth playing a prison right now is guilty of 100 more murders. It's all like me take up a vice cartel, don't it? Me not take up a vice cartel. And you'd have be a fool for thinking if you think that. And listen to me, you know. You'd have be a fool for really believe say me I take up a vice cartel. Me not taking up a vice cartel. Me I say, if the police head come on television and say, the man who get old for one murder, him is fingered for 100 more murder. What happened to the families of those people who was murdered? Aren't they in agony and pain now? If this is true. And the man, they gonna go resign now. And sit down and have them belly big like my one, you know, and I laugh. Oh, I've done a wonderful work for the government. And little more hear them name, sir this and sir that. And most honorable this and most honorable that. What a terrible thing. Look how much rasta brethren and sistren die and suffer under the hands of these governments over the years. And the one little time now when we see like a light at the end of the tunnel, them a bob and weave and a circumvent the whole thing. And when we think say Chucky didn't, up a Grand Spen, you know, me used to live at Grand Spen. Well, a barbecue me used to live, but a Grand Spen road. What I mean, I tell you, say the people them run a Grand Spen love Chucky, you know, I mean, love Delroy Chucky, you know. Yeah, them love him, man. Them love Chucky. I mean, say him not a good man, you know, because most of them politicians good people, you know. But bad people becomes really synonymous with them when they become ministers, and when them call them now councils and representatives of the state. The Minister of Justice, anybody who knows Mr. Delroy Chuck, tell him say Muta is saying that on October the 16th, he made a declaration that the Prime Minister of Jamaica will apologize in the coming weeks, that is from the October 16th, to the survivors of the Carroll Garden massacre. What him really mean when him say in the coming weeks? Because I am interpreting coming weeks to mean all when me dead and gone. Maybe 100 years from now. I don't know. But we need to know. The Tivoli Garden people, supposed to get compensation. When them say the Tivoli Garden people, they're supposed to get compensation. What they mean? Is this just something that is written on paper and a can to the Aguilar that they're going to come now and say, bring a lawyer? Why you must bring lawyer for? It's not trial you're going to. You're not going on trial. You're not on trial. I mean, what is this? What is this? That's why people have voted at 30% out of 500,000 people, out of nearly 1 million and something people vote. Nearly 2 million people vote. That is a disgrace. There's no confidence in the system that you can have an election and over 500,000 people vote out of 1.8 million people. I don't understand that. And then you have this party over here, so them have the great ideas them know when them not in power. Oh, what kind of madness that? Them have the, you hear them attack now? Oh, gosh, man. And then the next PNP party are threatening people. Oh my God, you never hear it. We can't play it, you know, we have the tape. A threaten, you know, it's like a bad woman thing, you know. A bad woman thing, oh. No girl, no guy, I tell you. No, them no easy, no rasta. Them no easy at all. Them no easy at all. And you know the way they sing, the whole of them go to church on Sunday, you know. The whole of them go to church on Sunday. You can't believe say some church people go to church on Sunday. Okay. This is a stepping razor. And yes. So we really want to find out if anybody listening to it who know the Minister of Justice, the Honorable, I must say most honorable, I was the Prime Minister name, most honorable. Am I honorable? Like me? Okay. All right. We want to, anybody who is listening to me, say to the Minister of Justice, did you really say, because I didn't play a tape, that boy, that Rasta boy who walk up and down barefoot, I didn't play a tape by you saying it's you. Maybe should libel, maybe should charge him for libel, because maybe it's them going to studio to configure the tape. But if it is you, did you actually say that in the coming weeks, the Prime Minister is expected to apologize to the survivors of the Carroll Garden? Did you actually say that, Chucky? I mean, Delroy Chuck? Minister, did you actually say that? I really want somebody to ask him. I want somebody to ask him. Because it's something, it's become like I not hear properly.
No, I mean, we had an ad hoc committee of parliament, you know, that sat and, in fact, have signed off. And we have made the recommendations, and those recommendations have come to cabinet. And cabinet, to the best of my knowledge, have signed off, though we have not specified specific action. Mm-hmm. But one of them, for example, is the amount of compensation that should be put in the fund for the victims, the survivors, and their relatives.
Yeah.
That amount has not been declared by cabinet as yet, but I can assure you that the apology for the Carroll Gardens, not only was it recommended by the public defender, but it will be delivered by the Prime Minister at a suitable time.
Mm-hmm.
And that, again, could be in a matter of weeks.
You're saying an apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister?
That is correct.
That's what you're saying, Minister?
Yes. An apology will be delivered by the Prime Minister on behalf of the government of Jamaica, as recommended by the public defender.
All right, and we should see that, you're saying, in the coming weeks.
In the coming weeks, okay.
All right. So, I hope it's not Cabo or Shamara going at the studio. Go get a actor for echo this voice, yeah. Because I will not take responsibility. The views expressed on that tape does not represent Muta Baruka and the Stepping Razor, nor IRFM. What is the sole responsibility of Cabo Mahateru and Shamara, the producer of Africa Forum? Okay, so we want to validate that tape, carry through scrutiny to really find out if it is the Minister of National Security, Jared Justice. Oh, we have a next one, we are just National Security, you know, Bobby Montague. You know, so the Minister of Justice rent one place up our average tree there, so. The Minister of Justice rent one place up our average tree there, right beside the marketplace. I don't know why them carry that place to go there. It looked like a hospital. It painted a blue and white, like a, I say, Minister of Justice. And I say, wow. I feel like it's open a business across the road. You know? May I tell you? Serious thing. Terrible. All right. So we want to know that it's 4 minutes past four, and this hour, the hour between four and five, is brought to you by Pete Butlin. In-season sorrel juice. Real homemade sorrel. May I tell you? I want to go out of my yard and get some of that sorrel there, you know. Believe you me. Sorrel juice are the nicest juice, you know. Sorrel juice, tamarind juice, and passion fruit juice. Nice juice. But sorrel juice is a very good juice for you. Yes, I mean, really want to tell you that. Separate apart from the advertisement. But me no say to help the advertisement. But me I tell you, this is sorrel juice. It have a whole heap of benefits. Especially if you put like a ginger in there. Don't put no white rum. Because Jamaican people love a talk about that Christmas. They have a typical white rum, not sorrel. Me not recommend you buy rum tonight. Just sorrel juice. Made from real sorrel. Trust me, man. Shamara, I'm going to buy some sorrel juice for you this Christmas. You understand? Real sorrel. Give the money. Woy. All right. This is the Stepping Razor. The art of war. Okay. We want to tell you that today is World AIDS Day 2016. Yeah. World AIDS Day. It's been... Aye, sir. All right. Them of our team here. Hands up for HIV prevention. I can say if I can put up my hand to prevent any HIV. See, the whole of the studio, except Shamara, put up her hand. So, is there a doctor in the house? Is there a doctor in the house? We need a doctor in the house with Shamara, so believe you me. Okay. Here we go. Well, this is the Stepping Razor, the art of war. Yes, yeah. Yeah,
General.
How are you, man?
Well, me they are give thanks, you know, give thanks for life and everything like that. You know?
Okay. Oh, your sounds are warped. Like your voice are warped away.
You hear me better now?
All right. Yeah. Me hear you better now.
Greetings.
All right, man. So, what we are saying now?
Me have some unfortunate incident, sir. From 2009, you know, and everybody has been sidelining, you know, what I am feeling. I have been scarred mentally.
Where you say everybody, everybody has sidelined, where you say? Because
the relevant authorities.
Okay.
People that, you know, can remedy such, you know, situations,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Nice. Because I know everybody has somebody that is in charge of them, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
All right, may I listen?
Yes, General. This all started, right? I'm a police constable, right?
He's a police constable.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right? I know you are the police officer on the YouTube.
No!
Or different policies.
These are the other one where they bet in the town of Mandeville.
Okay.
That was on the roof and them same shooting to kill himself.
Okay.
Yes, so I made a public apology.
But you never kill yourself, though?
No, sir.
So why you go up on the building and make people feel that way there? Diarrhea you want people have?
No, sir.
All right, so why you go up on the building to make people feel that?
There was a detective corporal, sir, the day before, right? She pulled a firearm on me.
Okay.
Right? And if I didn't have a tape, right, I wouldn't record certain things, right? She went for some other top rank officers, right? And they came over there, right? And even one of the officers picked up on himself to say that, you know, I should not conclude my time after me as a police, you know, police finish work, you know, and say, I must not conclude my time. I must lock up the diary. So they forced me out of the office. Right? I told them that I was going up on a roof the next day to jump. All of them tell me that
oh,
I must
you
go.
Tell them that?
Yes, man. Them tell me I must go and go jump.
Yeah.
He's a supervisor in my office, you know.
Yeah, tell must
I
go and go
don't
jump.
Jump it.
Okay.
Right?
So you go up there?
Yes, man. So the day after I went up there.
Yeah. So we stop you from jump?
Sir, I wasn't going to jump. I just wanted the media. I'm going through a lot of things. This started from November 2009, right? I was accused of larceny of a firearm.
No, well, right? I make it done with the jump thing first, though.
Yes.
You say you go up there and you never did go jump.
No.
So when you go up there, you know, you get the attention of everybody.
Yes, sir.
And then you come off.
Well, I was assisted to come down by the fire brigade.
Okay,
you understand?
Okay.
And some other people.
Yeah.
However, I had a little business place, right? That I beg and beseech, you know, say, want the media to come around here and I can talk to them and show them certain things, show them certain documents. Right now, I'm scanning certain documents and sending it to you. Right? The same ones that I wanted them to see.
Okay.
Right? But the hierarchy of the force, the Area 3 management team, right, issued a directive to go and get the policeman off the roof.
Take you off of the roof.
Yes, and stop bring the name of the Jamaica Constabulary Force in a disrepute.
Okay.
Right?
So where you do them now for you are involved? What happened? Why you and them in all of them wranglings? Eh?
Well, I am the agent of change. I was trained as the agent of change, right? And when they were training me, Jacqueline Martin told me it was not going to be easy.
No, hold on. Take me slow, because I'm slow, flying, you know, I'm really slow, you understand?
Yes.
When you say them train you to be the agent of change, what do you mean? Like JLP or PNP, you change them, where would go?
You change the officers to come out there and start a change.
Okay.
You understand?
Make a
because
difference.
They
make
had
a difference.
A vision 2030.
Yeah, you was trained to make a difference to the police force.
Nice.
Okay, all right. Yes.
Right? So me now coming to be the agent of change. This is my promotion, so to speak. Mm. This is my, you know, this is my payback. They are paying me.
Yes.
Nice. So I'm working. They are paying me.
May I hear you, man? Are we listening to your radio?
No, sir. I don't have a radio.
But you take a full stop too long, man. You take two full stop in a one full stop. Well, that no. You talk or
you
talk? Where you listen to, Bridget?
No, I listen to nothing.
Then talk, no, man. Say, so what happened now? You tell me a story. I mean, I can't talk the story.
So, I went on the roof. I set up the place.
No, we passed the roof now.
Coming around.
Yo, we passed the roof now, man. We are talking about now. Why is it that these people have something against you so much that you could have even threatened them? Say you are going to jump off our roof and don't jump off. Because you say you want to get a media attention. What was the media attention about? What was happening to you in that time why you want the media attention?
Sir, almost every year them stop my pay, right? I am treated like I am not an officer, right? These people wrongfully lock me up, like at will, lock me up, make up situations, put me there, lock me up.
Like, for instance, like what them lock you up for now? Tell me one of the things.
Shooting.
Them lock you up. You're a policeman. You're a policeman and them lock you up for shooting. And
yes, sir.
So in the come, they take up your case?
Sir, nice. I like that question. They did not allow Indicom to investigate it. They swept it under the carpet.
Okay.
They had the witness that they say I shot in Area 3 headquarters. And this was not Area 3 headquarters investigation. It's people that tell me back on all of the corruption. You understand?
Yeah.
They placed me on an identification parade. They took away my phone. The phone that I had, I was recording evidence of them, like video. When I got back my phone, there was nothing in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, and they are saying that they are putting me on an identification parade. Right, I went. You understand? Because I know I had nothing to do with it. I went.
Nothing to do with what? With the shooting? I have nothing to do with the shooting.
No, sir.
Okay.
You understand? This man, all right, this man that they allege that I shot is an extortionist. None of the police know of him. I took a picture of this man and I brought it to the ACT, the Assistant Commissioner in Charge. I brought it to a senior member in charge of an ops team, and I brought it to a Divisional Intelligence Unit person. I don't trust people because they have done me a lot, right? And I think it was some like minutes after the man was shot, or he was shot up. Right? He was shot up. Right? I tell them that this man, I've been observing this man for over a period of time. Not one day, not 3 days, not 4 days. And I see he's working with a team. And he's operating in the town of Mandeville under a camera where our tax dollars pay to put up these cameras. And I am telling the SP in charge of crime, sir, can you review the tape to see this man and his cronies? And the people, them lock me up. I say to the SP in charge of crime is a business. It's only Mr. Wisdom though on the pay list. That's why you lock me in the office. Because I am an operational person. You understand? And lo and behold, it's me them lock up, put me on ID parade, and even I'm on the ID parade and I'm not pointed out, they still take away my phone. This is corruption. They know what is in my phone. You understand?
So let me ask you a question. All right, so wait, no, because, you know, so we don't have the word here. What is it that you want to do I know you called for me to expose the thing.
Yes.
But what are you doing now to make this thing more justifying to you, that you can say you get some justice out of this thing? What are you doing now?
Sir, I am pursuing legal redress, legal action,
okay,
right? Because...
Okay.
There is a certain superintendent in charge of Manchester. She was transferred.
No, wait, no man. Listen to what I'm saying now. Because you're a police, you know the implications of implicating people. So you say you're a police, you understand?
Sir, I can't implicate them. Because they have said it. They have put it in the media.
I never hear it.
Well, I can tell you where to go. September 28th. The Jamaica Observer.
You know,
so
you start sound like a policeman to me, you know, you talk to me. I mean, not really why you start sound like a policeman, or you talk to me. You know,
nice. Read article September 28th, 2016.
All right. So, I'm going to make...
Then you will see what is happening.
All right. So, let me ask you a question now. What is it that... You get a liar? Because...
Sir, appears so much... Sir, I've been paying lawyers from 2009. Sir, I am so broke. They have stopped my pay the 24th of this month. For what? Nothing. I am selling in sick leave. They lick me up with handcuffs since I come off of the roof because they don't want me to see the media. You understand? So I am no... I am not angry
now.
I am not reminding them.
You're there on the media now. You're there on the media.
Yes.
Hold on there. Because we're going to have a thing named Music News right now. So I don't know if you want...
No problem.
If you want old,
I will.
Come back to you. You come back to you. All right. Make go and talk till I'm ready for the music news. Make go and talk. All right. So we are saying no.
Father Muta, this is not about me. This is about the people who had suffered, who are suffering, and who will suffer. You understand? It's not about me. You understand? And if you can do your internal customers the way you do me, imagine John Public, imagine a Mr. Muta Baruka.
No, me no want imagine it, you know.
Nice.
Yeah, but yeah, no, I go imagine it. So,
but it is inevitable. You understand? So you need not hide from it. It's like death. It's appointed unto man once to die.
Mm.
So if we say we want to accomplish Vision 2030, the Jamaica Constabulary will be a stumbling block because we keep promoting the people.
The Jamaica Constabulary Force is a stumbling block to the Vision 30.
I mean, you have to invest in security, sir. If you're not doing it, sir, you're not much man in jail right now because of injustice.
Because of corruption.
Nice. You understand? Nice. Virgin, I just get out my thing first before I talk about where I can talk about. But all of
you
say
that about you. It's not about you, you say. You don't say that about you already. Yeah.
Nice.
All right, so yeah, I said the police force have a whole heap of corruption that take place. And yes, some of the corruption was directed to you personally.
Repeat, I didn't hear that.
You are saying that the police force have a lot of corruption in it, and a lot of that corruption was directed to you personally.
Yes, sir. And I am a young officer, right? And
How old is?
29.
You're 29. Yeah, you're a young boy. Yes, sir. You're a young boy.
Of course.
Yes. And you got to all of this thing with the police force from 2009.
I am a referee and I had to stop refereeing game.
And you don't get no redress up to now? You don't get no redress?
No, sir.
Eh?
None whatsoever. No, I have brought them to Supreme Court. Right?
Yeah.
I have brought them to Supreme Court because I wrote to the commissioner on June 12, 2010.
Mm.
Right?
Mm.
And I wrote through Patterson Muir Hamilton, attorney at law, right? I got no response, right? We again wrote to the then commissioner on June 20, 2010. We got no response. And I can read what it said. On September 7, 2009, Council Wisdom, having been charged with license of a firearm and license of ammunition, was suspended from duty without pay. Right? It is saying the suspension notice dated September 7th, Council Wisdom was acquitted on June 9th after a successful no case submission, by attorney at law Peter Champagne. Having regard to Regulation 44 of the Police Service Regulation 1961, Council Wisdom has advised that he informed the then superintendent, Menaka Alonium, of his acquittal. But to date, no one has contacted him about his reinstatement or his outstanding salary payment.
All right. Hold on there, because I can't make you read all that. You go up to the Commissioner of Police Headquarters office.
That is a good question, sir.
Yeah, well,
sir, I have been writing to the Commissioner of Police from May the 10th, 2018.
Let me ask you a while ago.
Sir, I have went up there. I am not given the chance. I have not been granted the chance to see the commissioner, any one of them.
So when you go up there, you never see the commissioner?
Sir, I am not given the chance.
How much time you go up there already?
One heap of time, sir. May I go up there to collect documents because I am now an administrative person. So I go to the commissioner office to let off documents sometimes.
So they have you in the office as a policeman?
Yes, sir.
You know they're on the road again?
No, sir.
Oh, them not trust you?
No, sir. But my shot, man. Them friend. Well, yes, sir.
Them say you chat, man, but you never chat no man.
No, sir. And I requested, I made a valid request that CC cameras be reviewed. And it asked them, sir,
them
you
know
can ask
review
them.
Them ask them
what of the CC cameras?
Me no, ask them. Yeah,
yes,
ask
sir.
Them, I know. Yeah. All right. Eva Bridget, you see this thing, I know, sound like a thing where we can't really get to the seriousness of it in a chat space of time where we have.
I know.
Yeah. So, I don't know where you want, though. But you have to go really tell me where you want to do fast, you know, because I have a next program I come up near Music News. I want to go into it. So you tell me exactly where you want me do and where you want happen.
Sir, I would like to see National Integrity Action. Because I will be resigning. Because they have said that they don't want me there. So maybe I am the problem. So I want to see National Integrity Action. I can take it from there.
All right, sir. So you know who forgot to?
Sir, I don't know, and it is not safe. It is not safe for me now, traveling in Jamaica. Because it works,
you're not safe now, like when you talk on the radio.
Yes, sir, but we don't coward so much.
And if you don't coward, no, you're worried about you're not safe at all right now, Jamaica.
Yeah, but I have to tell you, I have to put it out there in the public domain, in case, the judge and jury.
In case. in case anything happens, you know, so you'll have a car, you talk, and because you take a stand.
Well, we have this warrior genetics, you know. You understand? So,
yeah.
You don't know. All we right. have to play, you understand, our yeah. part in advancement of the whole
human race. Yes, yes,
yes. Yes, yes, yes. You understand?
Well, Bridget.
But we just have to play my part.
Yeah, man.
You understand?
We give thanks to hear from you. And as we are
saying. Why we can't see the commissioner from 2011 to now? Deep in our man.
Yeah.
Well, so as a gunman have information.
As a policeman, you should be able to see the commissioner of police.
Nice, sir. Thank
because
you.
If you not see the police commissioner of police, can you imagine me go up there?
Sir, but me get injured on duty since me go up on the roof and them stop my pay. I am supposed to be going to Turpin now and them stop my pay. What is happening?
Yeah, well, them could have stopped me up there so because me is who me is to because them have said me want to see the commissioner of police, so them go arrest me because me want to see him. Anyway, Bridget. We really give thanks and you really call and, you know, gross this thing here because, may I tell you, you have other policemen out there that like talk, but...
Sir Mota.
Yes.
There is a person where I send for a lease and I don't have no lease to my credit.
Yeah.
And I can't give you the date. The date is the 15th of the 1st, 2003.
Yeah.
Right. Then I'm going to give it a light to put on a police car when we are at work and it's not a service vehicle.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
You see, but you I like talk to you more, but as me I say, we have a program that come up.
Sir, you can call me anytime.
Anytime,
we'll
defend
the program.
All right, hold on. The program
not come. Yeah, I cannot send you some documents.
Yo, the program not come yet. The program we're supposed to cut you off not come yet, so...
Well, we'll give you some more information.
Yeah, give me the information.
You understand me? Give you some more
and you have to send me them information, don't you? Don't you have to send me the information, them?
Of course. All right. I got injured, right? I've been assaulted by senior members. Members in khaki suits. I have went to Indicom to investigate certain things, right? Indicom, right, is sending me to Kingston because I'm dealing with certain people in Kingston, right? They are sending me to Kingston. Now I go to Kingston. They are sending me back to Mandeville. This cannot be happening. You understand? Just because they know that I am now the police officer that used to operate with a certain member in Clarendon that was charged for murder for extrajudicial killing. You understand?
Yeah.
It's not right. Me can't, me a young youth, me that's can't true. Bear the pressure for no man, virgin.
Yes. I understand.
You understand?
That. Yeah.
It's not right. And I am sir, if I get 8.5 million to give each, may I tell you, me just a break up. If me get some money for break up, give the man in my lump sum, I am going to speak something that will pull down the Jamaica Constabulary Force.
All right, so
and
we have to move.
Corruption.
Yeah, all right, we have to move, Bridget. Give thanks, yeah?
All right, General.
Yeah, all right, yes. The man, they have a whole heap of girls against the force, and him is a police, too. Understand? So you must know, so if it's an internal thing, I go on there, so. Can we hear of another man who come out against the police force, so who is a police, too, you know? And you have a whole heap of them out there like that. You talk to them one-on-one, you know, so that's everything. This is the stepping razor. The art. Of war.
Yeah, Africa must unite. Stop your fuss and your fight. Yeah, Africa must unite. Come together and fight for your right. Africa must unite. Don't you know unity is strength to life? Africa must unite. Come together and fight for your right. Africa must unite. Don't you know unity is the strength to lie? We must come together. No matter
what nation
or color.
Yeah.
Yes, hello.
Yeah, blessed man.
Yes, good day, sir. This is the bike messenger that called you a few weeks ago.
What messenger?
Bike messenger. You know, I told you I like a lot of vintage stage shows. The Jacob Miller when he took the police officer's hat.
Yeah, so you was not the first One World Ska and Rock City Festival.
Okay, well, I'm involved with a beautiful empress. You know, I'm a bike messenger in New York City, so, you know, I can't leave. You know?
You can't leave
but
New York.
But
you can't leave
sorry.
New York. Wait, so you can't leave New York?
Oh, I can, but, you know, all right, my mother's from Sheffield, so, you know, I've been around in a different continent, but I'm an African that was born in America, and I understand the psychology and how you know, you speak, and it's just so deep, but I want to give you some Kanishan architecture, history about Kemet.
Wait there, yeah. Right, hey, wait there, hold on there.
Yeah.
You hear me ask you a while ago?
Sorry, yes. What was the question?
Did you hear what I asked you a while ago? The question I asked.
Or if I could leave New York.
No. No, that's not what the first question I asked you. I asked you. You said that you love certain kind of music.
Yes, sir.
And you love the thing about Jacob Miller in the old, you love those kind of old songs. And I asked
and, stage show.
And
yes,
I
sir.
Asked you if you were at the One World Ska
okay,
and
no, I wasn't.
Festival. Okay, that's what I asked you.
Yeah, because, you know, all right, I just wanted, because sometimes when I call you, you know, I can't recite certain things. But I heard you also speaking to Josie Wales. And, you know, I've been from, I'm 29 now, but, you know, I have relatives who had different dancehall tapes and just seeing how funny he was on the mic. But before I leave you, I would just love to give you a few words of what he said at Jack Ruby 28th anniversary in 1986.
Mm. 1986.
Yeah, so, you know, sorry?
1986.
Yeah, and I was born in 87, so I have an old soul, you know, and I love, yes. I just love them dancehall stage shows from the 80s.
Yes, yes, yes.
And, yes, so this is a place in Kemet called the Serapeum.
Yes.
And there's like 20 boxes. One box is 100 tons. The lid is 30 tons, and the bottom box is 70 tons. And this is so amazing. There's certain white people that take this stuff serious. And there's the Egyptians that, Egyptologists that's fighting against certain geologists that's trying to prove to the world that, yes, Egypt is older than we think. But check this out now. To me, I'm so straightforward like you. When you cut through all the extra political talk and how they talk, the thing is that when they go back, they see it was black people inhabited Egypt first. And then other people that descended from us, period, that a few thousand years later, that come back around again to come back to Kemet and see like how the Greek architectures came first and seeing such beautiful things. And they went back to Greece and built Greece. But it's just, and the people who run the world know this, but they're jealous of our accomplishments. So, you know, that's why I don't want you stressed. That's why, you know, I don't want you to stress yourself too much getting a point across, but like you told Mandingo, that they can't stop. You're just always going to keep repeating the same thing.
Yeah, man, give thanks.
Yes, thanks. All right. And before you block me off, I just wanted to tell you a little something what Josie Wells said.
Mm.
All right. Always to the Colonel, always to the Colonel, chief, they buy that box. Always to the Colonel, always to the Colonel, chief, they buy that box. Yes, I one box, me want a Jack of Obi sound box. One box, me want one, is a strong box, yes. Look how me big, look how me fat, how me feet jump fence. With ballad box, always to the Colonel, always to the Colonel.
All right, sir, give thanks, so, you know, give thanks. You have talent,
yes, sir.
You have talent, give thanks.
Yes, sir.
All right, yes. Stepping Razor, yes, deal.
Hey, yes, sir.
Stepping Razor.
Well, you hear me now. It not sound like the voice of the most honorable, but in voice of talk to you and the one when I mind sound different. So take sound out of mind. So you look a barefoot youth.
Yes.
You come and hold me to promises. You know, it's like election time just run.
Yeah.
You have to wait now till the next election. Maybe me make the prime minister come promise himself.
Yes. Okay. That me that's it too. But me no hold to them promises. I just threw the people them whole and pan it why me really I make them statement they still.
And they make it publicly too.
May I tell you? Make them statement publicly.
Mm-hmm. What me have to do? You know, I ask the police out there, why the woman corporal pull gun ban him? When you hear that, man.
Okay.
You said the woman pull the gun ban him, you know, and then call him bigger head down kind of thing.
Yeah.
And I'm with me, did that sound tape, we can get out of some prior problems. And my jump for a story, the story. So
well, give the reasoning, course. When me and him had prior to this conversation, it's like, them are claim say, him kind of lose it.
Well,
that's what them are say.
When him talk like, when talking like, you sound like, you know, jump to do.
Yeah, what
him
say, when
him just want. Jump, erratic.
Him just want publicity, if you make them out, people aware of. where them are door and where the corruption of the police force.
That's but where in that me curious now to know how thing that I got mass up the world force when you want 8 million for.
May I tell you?
The hell of a story that.
Stay tuned for the next episode.
Man, that if the star lives to see the next episode.
Him same no business. The one to put my car at them, you know. Enter them a Lego store, you know. Them no business.
If my listener work, you know, so when next time you tape and you have something, you have to make copy and I have the video. You just make them take
it
away.
Smash it up. Yeah, just delete it.
Yeah, that means I'm good on the talk before saying got it.
Them now watch Law and Order, man. Them need to watch Law and Order.
Nah, let them see what they do. We wonder sometimes when enough people them see what they do. Hey, but love the show last night. Well, it's what them usually good anyway.
I love it.
Great night.
What happened is that, you mean the Cuban thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the Fidel Castro. Yeah, Fidel Castro vibes. That's a very honest documentary about Fidel Castro. It never bias, you know, because him still show you say him really do a whole heap of damage and create a whole heap of things.
I do. Yeah, but in the fourth couple of little things that we know first and what we see. Yeah. Well, maybe then I eat this dance. Yeah. Remember all the Marielito there, you know, man? The Marielito there, boat lift there. Yeah. That's the people crowd, and the amount of money them boatmen they make.
Yeah, man.
Car people. My boat car money that run a Miami them time, you know, man?
Yeah,
of course. Make money and run, you know? Mm-hmm. Man, I spend money, you know, because the amount of money run down there in Haiti. It says if you go down there, go work more Federal Reserve Bank down there, you know, man? And when you look out for the west side, so how for the Cuban and below there and the Colombian name?
May I tell you?
Man?
I must say the mafia did run Cuba one at a time too, you know?
Yeah.
Mafia did run Cuba, yeah. So,
nothing them and stuff in there, man. Nothing them. But you know what I'm saying? And the same Kennedy, them mixed up in there, and that's why them are using Cuba. The mafia, them. So I remember say all them make for their money. And yes. Rum running, you know?
Yeah, him father.
During the booze days
when it was illegal.
Surgical.
I saw them make their money.
Yeah, Al Capone get all the blame. Good things Al Capone do all this, you know.
Yeah, but wait, you know the thing with it, I come and say it all the while, say, I'm in a dark out of a bubble. You have a whole heap of businessman. Right on the North Coast, that stretch go right to Negril.
Mm-hmm.
Who are big businesses where the first money where they make was cocaine and ganja they make it off, you know.
There you go.
And them is big, respectable people, but the same with the Kennedy them.
The smart ones do that, you know.
Joseph Kennedy, I think Joseph Kennedy him the name.
Yeah, I remember my name.
Yeah, they make the first money where they make was half illegal trading with this and. Connection with the mafia and all them something there. I know them are big, respectable people, you know what I mean?
But that's what the smart one them, you know. They must remember this Italian mafia. Take time, they legalize land, you know, then got the big thing about land, your money, your land.
Landering, yes.
And put in all legal, them go college, you know, turn lawyer, turn this, turn that, what legal business is.
Defend them too.
And you know, it's illegal, that's what the smart money do, you know.
Yeah, so I know.
They turn it out longer and longer and go and let them have 16 and
I know, I bet you mention, say, a whole heap of hotel we have been in Jamaica, money laundering money from different countries. People are going to say, me, I try and make trouble. Evidence? They must say, where the evidence there, you know. Where the evidence for that? And them know, you know. You know what hurt me? Them know, see, I show me a talk, you know, but I show me a say it. Yes.
No fight for an election, too.
Oh, you mean, man? Behave yourself, man. All right, sir, give thanks.
Yeah,
step in. Here.
Muta.
Blessed, man.
Wagwan.
Where are we there?
I know, Muta. You don't know, so me, I drop back in the court Wednesday, the 7th of December.
You drop back in the court?
Yeah, man, I'm there for the chair, listen, you know.
Why you sound happy? Tell me where I go, because you sound so happy, like everything's set up and you get money and all them something there.
Why, Muta, me not get no money now, but my daughter's birthday is 7th of December, so me I got caught with her looking out for a blessing.
Okay. All right, so tell me where did I go on now. Tell me where I go on now, so now with the quoting.
Well,
first of all, tell the people who me talk to. This is the lady who...
Was beat by the tourist court to pick up them.
Yeah, beat up.
Yeah, man. They are mash up here with a motor, but me a whole on to life, though.
Yeah, so what you do now? What you do? Meanwhile, what you do?
Well, I mean, I don't know.
You still out of the crap market, you still...
Yeah, man, me go out there sometime, but you know, I pressure, so me just go and easy myself, because me no want to get back in the system with no problem, is it?
Mm-hmm.
So me just step on a low profile, is it, motor?
Yeah. So where you say about the court? When are the court?
The 7th of December, that's a Wednesday I come.
Okay. So they're going to try it now, or they're going to call it up? Which one?
All right. A trial. Every document they put on file now says trial. I'm on the trial list.
Okay. That sounds like something we're supposed to. How long you think that's going to last now?
I hope for the best. I don't know how long it's going to last for, but Mr. Thomas said the 7th of December trial.
Yes. So, all right. I'm glad you keep me in farm still. You know,
why, Muta? I don't want to Muta me ever. Me sit down every program you come for me listen, you know, Muta.
Yeah.
He's a blessed man. He's a blessed. He's a blessed, Muta.
All right, Mama.
That's it.
All right.
When I say a word, me, I go keep you. Me know a seminar. I can't talk to you Wednesday. But Thursday,
Thursday,
me,
tell you where I go on at the court.
Tell me, I go tell you where I go on, Muta, because you know some knowledge and tell you where I go on.
All right, Mama.
I have to keep you up to date. As I say, I 3 years, so as I say, I hope for the best.
I'm going to deal with you for the whole 3 years.
For the whole 3 years, Muta, you know, let me down. Me fi, Muta, you're blessed, man.
All right, Mama.
Yeah, man. I mean, I'm a little youth, them there, go on, them come from school, and everybody happy, them I eat some food, and me just call and say, listen, me now go court without me tell you what go on. And when me come from court, me I tell you what go on.
Go on, yes. All right, yeah. Give thanks.
So now say a word, Muta. Bless up yourself, eh? Yeah.
Step in, yeah.
Aye. Muta.
Yes, sir.
What, me I tell you, star, the coming life, the man then use the crime for joke, Muta.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Come like the man then use this crime for joke, me, I tell you, star. You know, see it?
Which man them? And which crime?
The killer have? Them, the killer them, and the gunsman them.
Yeah, why you tell them I use it for joke?
Because right now, the man them be like a cowboy thing and a show them, you know?
Mm.
See? Yes, man. The man them make Jamaica look a weird rasta. The man them won't go plant ground and stop the fooling it, you know, see it?
Yeah.
You know, see, every day the man them get up, come up with them crime and them kill and murder and them little thing, and look how much land there. And no fight land there, naya. The man have to go plant, man. Pull on them little thing there, yeah. You know, see it. And call up on the jaw. You know, see it. And stop with them foolishness. Because right now, them people, them are kill out. And even if I and I found them to, you know, fire. See?
Mm.
Yeah, man, I was a rasta man. I talk more, the man them hear me. You know, see it? Now, I beg the man, them man, to stop them thing the rasta. You can't make Jamaica look every day, so. You know, see it like that. Look at the boss with them kill every day. All that man, they don't have to validate. Them things are not right. Now, listen to the thing in here. The thing man can't feel good in them country, so rasta.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? Man can't feel good here. You know, see it? The man, them to stop them thing, the man. They been a rugged boat, that man. You know, see it? Because right now, I and I want to go out then, but enjoy myself. I and I have a fret. You know, see it? I and I have a fret. Enough to go so. Enough to go so, man. You know, see it? And right now, no for the rest of them to, them to come together and hold a meet and make do a thing, you know. You know, see it?
Like, yes, what, like what you want them to do? Tell me. Like what you want them to do?
Yeah, we want a man them farm again and make a thing that. We call it then lifehouse then. Life we are dealing with.
Farmer gang, we call it lifehouse.
Yeah? Life. We just build a thing named life.
Where the gang
life for
do?
Living.
So where the gang you know, go do? Where the gang go do?
Eh?
Where the gang go do?
Well, right now, I think the gang make the man them change, you know. It's everyone come together and make a life love. Or a life forever then. And that's the foolishness.
No, but where the gang go do? Where them go do? Where, as they're coming together, where the gang go do?
The gang, I go just farm a love. A love gang. A house of love. You know, see it. And everyone come show them love. And live off of that tire. You know, see it. It's a gang of love we are dealing with. You know, see it. See it? Yes, sir. Yeah. Because right now, you have a Jacka Club's house there. And many Rasta come a Jacka Club's house there, you know.
Where Jacka Club's house there? Where Jacka Club's
in St. Thomas, Marant Bay, Bambi River.
Yeah, but...
You know, see it.
Say,
you never hear about the club, you never hear about the house there yet.
No, I never hear about the house there
yet. Me Rasta come there, man, and a man no say if him have him heart clean or anything, him just come, and nobody come with him dirty ways, you know that, you know, lift that before him come in, that. Yeah. Because if him come in, he can't eat nothing, drink nothing, he would have liable to drop down, because it's a righteous house. Okay. See him?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, man, you know, see, if a man is righteous, mm-hmm. and he ain't not clean, yeah, him can't enter that the house there, you know.
All right.
You hear it, name?
Jacka
Club's house forever.
Jacka Club sound like that sound like a card game playing there.
Eh?
That sound like a whole card game playing there.
No man is a house, you know, but
so why them call it play there? Why them call it Jacka Clubs?
And the name, the passion of the house, it being just like a Jacka Clubs. It's a one of your house that.
No,
hold on.
I don't really want to get a long conversation. I'm going to go down. But when I ask you,
yeah.
Me know where Jacka Clubs is, you know. In a card park.
Yeah. You know about that one. But so your house, so you never see that house here.
I ask you, why them call it Jacka Clubs? Why them call
it? Because it built just like a Jacka Clubs. And we just name Jacka Clubs house.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. The patternite.
Yeah, the patternite.
Everyone come there and see it and say, why them like the design.
Okay.
You know, see it?
Like a Jacka Clubs.
Yes, Joe said we like a Jacka Clubs here. Me don't like the see the house there in the fire.
And when me see the house, what happened?
Eh?
Just to satisfy my eye.
Well, every that, because I can't talk about it, say, boy, I love the pattern and every that. Every that, because it's enlightened in a motor. Yeah, I talk to your motor, you enlightened Jatabi, you know.
Yeah, me know, but you see...
You think me just talk to you, so you motor enlightened higher than I.
No, but me know, you know what I talk to you, when me ask you now. Wait there.
Eh?
Who are talking to me now? But when I say you sound simplistic when you tell me now, say you for farm a house named Jacka Clubs and just love. That kind of sounds simplistic to me.
Stop
the crime and violence by just come and farm a gang named Love and we just love and that is it. That's why I trip on some acid trip and all them way there now when we talk. Anyway,
motor, the house of love, you know, see it.
Yeah,
but
right,
we just make a design name, Jacka Clubs, you know, right, see it.
Yeah. Give time, we have to move, though.
Blessed motor.
Yes, we're there with you. Stepping Razor, IRFM. Okay, so we're there in the last moment of the program, you know. We want to give thanks for all who participate in the program. We want to give thanks to Young. We want to give thanks to Shamara. The Virgin by my name again. Eh?
Romain,
you know, so I remember it, but I doubt myself. I feel like I was a Romain Virgo. I want you up Romain. Round this one. I want you up the operator. How much operator we go through since 2 o'clock? Yeah? Vivian, you up here? I want to remind you that the hour between 5 and 6 is brought to you by Caribbean Cream. All right, you over here, so now. We are playing this show now. Believe you me, we are playing this show. Here we go. What did? You know, say a false start, that. Total false start. All right. All right. So, we want yellow pal, so Vita. Yes, I'm hungry. We want yellow Neil, taxi driver. Blessed Neil. Why you get demoted from engineer to taxi driver? Why I forgot to tell your mother. I'm in love with mother, this man. Why mother love me to do? She said she don't miss stepping razor, but mommy, the man get demoted. Man turn taxi driver down IRFM, you know. Romain take him over, you know. Romain look like him too, you know. Romain look like him, little uglier, but Romain look like him, serious. All right. So you have to know. Next week. Cutting Edge from 10 to 2 o'clock. I don't know, we're there again. Where are you coming up for Deal? Deal Road coming up to Martin.